everybody. Thank you, Kim, for asking me to come. Henry would have really enjoyed this show, I'm sure. He really liked pussy. There's a lot of pussy going on here. I grew up in Western Massachusetts in a sort of shitty dead mill town.
Put a gag in there.
What Henry was feeling when he first started writing. I was lying in the dark, a little twig floating in the Japanese current. I was getting back to simple abracadabra, the straw that makes bricks, the crude sketch, the temple which must take on flesh and blood and make itself manifest to all the world. I got up and put on soft light. I felt calm and lucid, like a lotus opening up. No violent pacing back and forth, no tearing the hair out by the roots. I sank slowly into a chair by the table, and with a pencil, I began to write. I described in simple words how it felt to take my mother's hand and walk across the sunlit fields, how it felt to see Joey and Tony rushing towards me with arms open, their faces beaming with joy. I put one brick upon another like an honest bricklayer. Something of a vertical nature was happening, not blades of grass shooting up, but something structural, something planned. I didn't strain myself to finish it. I stopped when I had said all I could. I read it over quietly, what I had written. I was so moved that the tears came to my eyes. It wasn't something to show an editor. It was something to put away in a drawer to keep as a reminder of natural processes, as a promise of fulfillment. Every day we slaughter our finest impulses. That is why we get a heartache when we read those lines written by the hand of a master and recognize them as our own, as the tender shoots which we stifle because we lack the faith to believe in our own powers, our own criterion of truth and beauty. Every man, when he gets quiet, when he becomes desperately honest with himself, is capable of uttering profound truths. We all derive from the same source. There is no mystery about the origin of things. We are all part of creation, all kings, all poets, all musicians. We have only to open up, only to discover what is already there. Thanks.
So I can say so many things about Henry Miller, but I will say this a lot. People who know me probably have heard me say at least one time that Henry Miller is the reason I'm a writer, but she did not impress me as an out and out whore. That she would go with me and take money for it, I knew, but that doesn't make a woman a whore. She put a hand on me and, like a trained seal, my pepper rose jubilantly to her delicate caress. Contain yourself, she murmured. It's bad to get excited too quickly. Let's get out of here, I said, beckoning the waiter. Yes, she said, let's go somewhere where we can talk at leisure. The less talking, the better, I thought to myself as I gathered my things and escorted her to the street. A wonderful piece of ass, I reflected, watching her sail through the revolving door. I already saw her dangling on the end of my cock, a fresh, hefty piece of meat waiting to be cured and trimmed. And at this point, I'm thinking, thanks, Dad. Remember, this is a kiss.
Yeah, it was kind of like kismet when Tim asked me if I wanted to do this reading, because he didn't know that I had a book called Pussy out. And actually, I'm in love with the cover, which is why I made t-shirts. And my friend, Michael Willis, who's here, actually designed it. I shoot hot bolts into you, Tanya. I make your ovaries incandescent. Your Sylvester is a little jealous now. He feels something, does he? He feels the remnants of my big prick. I have set the shores a little wider. I have ironed out the wrinkles. After me, you can take on stallions, bulls, rams, drakes, St. Bernards. You can stuff toads, bats, lizards, other rectum. You can shit arpeggios if you like, or string a zither across your navel. I am fucking you, Tanya, so you'll stay fucked. And if you are afraid of being fucked publicly, I will fuck you privately. I will tear off a few hairs from your cunt and paste them on Boris's chin. I will bite into your clitoris and spit out 2 franc pieces.
Some house cooking. Suddenly, I love cooking. For Henry. I cook cook richly, with infinite care. I enjoy seeing him eat, eating with him. We sit in the garden in our pajamas, drunk on the air, the caresses of the swaying trees, the songs of birds, a tented dog licking our hands. Henry's desire is always coursing. I am cloud, open. At night, books, talk, passion. As he pours his passion into me, I feel that I become beautiful. I show him 100 faces. He watches me. It all passes like a procession, up to this morning's climax, before he leaves me, when he sees my burnt face, heavy, sensual, Moorish. There was a storm last night, marble-sized hail, sea fury of the trees. Henry sits in an armchair and asks, are we going to read Spengler now? He sits purring like a cat. He has the yawn of a tiger, all the jungle cries of contentment. His voice vibrates in his stomach. I have put my head there and listened, as against an organ. I am lying on the bed. I wear a lace dress, nothing else, because it gives him pleasure to look at me. Now, he says, I cannot bear the space between us. I sit on the floor, he caresses my hair, he gives me winged kisses on the eyes. He is all tenderness, thoughtfulness. Sensuality was exhausted in the afternoon, but he looks down and shows me his lance desire again. He himself is surprised. I love you. I wasn't even thinking of fucking, but your touch alone. I sit on his knees, and then we sink into the drunkenness of sucking for a long, long time, just tongues, eyes closed. We roll on the floor until I cannot bear anymore, and I lie still, saying no. But when he helps me off with my dress and embraces me from behind, I leap up to him, all aflame again.
It was his night off, and there was a cunt in his bed as usual. Don't mind her, he says. She's asleep. She almost wore me out. By this time, the one in the bed had come too and was rubbing her eyes. She looked pretty young to me too. Not bad looking, but dumb as hell. Wanted to know right away what we were talking about. She lives in the hotel, said Carl, on the third floor. Do you want to go to her room? I'll fix it up for you. I didn't know whether I wanted to or not, but when I saw Carl mushing it up with her again, I decided I did want to. I asked her at first if she was too tired. Useless question. A whore is never too tired to open her leg.
Thinking, for searching, for searching, oh, no, power lines, power lines.